Statement, I rise briefly to speak on the Statutes Amendment Civil Enforcement Bill. This is a new version of a bill that, as the Honourable Ms Lensink has pointed out, was first brought before us in 2021. Some honourable members may recall back then that the Greens were supportive of the bill, and we also supported a proposal from the then Labor opposition to make some changes to the bill. The bill before us today aims to address a concern the Honourable Kaya Maher, I believe, had at that time, which was regarding the implications of this reform for people on low incomes and looking at how garnishee orders could result in them not being able to meet their financial needs. The new clause that aims to protect low-income workers could have some adverse effects for those who have inconsistent incomes. The Greens are concerned that there may be people who work as a casual employee or work seasonally who could be impacted. And indeed, as the Honourable Connie Benares pointed out, a submission from the Law Society raised these concerns about the implementation of the clause, given the fact that a seasonal or periodic worker may earn significantly more than a national minimum wage in a short period of time, and then they may earn nothing for the remainder of the year. In such circumstances, when averaged over a year, it's possible that a garnishee could earn less than 90% of the minimum wage, but they'd still be required to pay in those weeks where they earned a greater amount. And I recognise, of course, that wasn't the government's intent, but that could have been an effect. We have worked with the government to improve the bill and to ensure that it is fairer for people who live on inconsistent incomes. And I understand the government will be advancing an amendment to address that concern that's been raised by the Greens and others, and we're certainly supportive of that. The other issue that the Greens had some concerns about was the protection of personal information supplied under investigation notices. In the last year, we have seen multiple examples of data breaches that have resulted in personal information being compromised, and we know that that has significant implications for our community. Most recently, there's been the Medibank saga, the Optus saga, and others. The Law Society has raised concerns about personal information being obtained under an investigation notice and the need for this to be protected from uses other than that for which it was intended. We will therefore be moving an amendment to ensure that these protections are in place. The Greens will be supporting the bill with the amendments that I have outlined. Thank you.